Hey guys, just a few days ago, there was a leak that indicated that it's possible that they might have remastered Modern Warfare 2 and it could release this year. Someone happened to catch a listing where it was for sale on Amazon, and it was the Italy Amazon site. Here's the actual listing here that was on Amazon. Now this has currently been removed and was removed pretty quickly the same day that it kind of blew up all over the internet. It's in Italian, but you can see that it says COD MW2 Remastered for PlayStation. It's €19.99 in euros. Here's the translated version into English, and it's saying that it's by Activision, being sold by Activision, that it's going to release on April 30th, 2018. There was no image that was added to it, but you can see that it's available for PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. After this blew up all over social media, people were questioning the legitimacy of it, wondering, you know, if it was faked. I looked into it because I wanted to find out, yeah, could you indeed fake this on Amazon? I know you can sell things on Amazon, and you know, is it possible that you could be a seller and fake this listing? From my experience, it's kind of a pain in the ass to set up a seller's account on Amazon. It's not like you just go to eBay and start selling. I mean, they want credentials from you, and they want you to prove yourself as a legitimate seller before they allow you to start selling. I was able to set up a basic seller's account. I was actually able to call it Activision Blizzard, like that was available as a seller's name, so that's possible. And here's my seller's dashboard right here. This page here shows that I was able to acquire the Activision Blizzard display name, and I can sell in those three markets. But getting to this point certainly was not easy. I had to have a valid credit card, so I had to give them all that information. I also had to have a valid banking account, so I had to give them like my routing number and account number for that. I also had to fill out tax documents where I had to give them like valid social security numbers and birthdays and things like that. Then finally, they wanted me to upload like my driver's license, you know, scan a picture. They wanted me to upload my bank statements and stuff like that. So they're not messing around here, but this is where I was like, no, I'm not going that far with this. So what I'm trying to say here is if it was like a young person that doesn't have all these credentials, it would be very challenging for them to actually get a legitimate account set up. I guess it's always possible that somebody jumped on somebody else's account and like accessed it and made a fake listing. But I don't think that's the case. I think this is a legitimate listing, and I'll show you one more reason why. And there's one big concern about how this listing looked. And this person here that responded to Charlie Intel that was posting about it kind of sums it up pretty well, and a lot of people were thinking the same thing. But they said that it looks fake. They wouldn't label it COD. That looks so unprofessional, which is a really good point. And I think most of us thought that immediately. One person responded to try to explain, and they said, as a former Amazon employee, the abbreviation COD in MW2 could very well be a placeholder. And they said that they're not a troll, and that the person that's managing the Italian domain is going to get in a lot of trouble for this. I looked more into the COD abbreviation to find out, is this something that they would actually put as a label or placeholder? And I did try to contact Amazon Italy, but you know, the language barrier, and they did have somebody respond to me in English. But basically what they said is they don't know anything. They think the product will become available soon, but it seemed like they didn't really know what they were talking about. The good news is that it did not take me very long to find the answers that I was looking for regarding the possibility that these listings would be labeled in such a simple, you know, abbreviated way. They labeled it COD MW2 Remastered-PlayStation 4. So yeah, a lot of abbreviations here. Well, if you go to Amazon Italy and look at their other Call of Duty listings, they label them the exact same way. I found three listings that, you know, showed the extreme abbreviations and not spelling everything out. And the first one at the top is almost like the leaked listing, and it says just COD MWR Remastered. It's got the dash and then the console. There's two other listings down at the bottom, and yeah, it just shows you that this is how they do it in Italy. The listings are, you know, pretty simple, and they like to abbreviate. I think that if someone were trying to fake this listing, they would want to spell it all out and make it look really fancy. I don't think they would, you know, use the abbreviations unless they knew that's what Italy does. But then again, it's so difficult to set up a seller's account. It would just be so hard to fake this. In addition to that, there is overwhelming evidence that Activision would definitely be remastering this and, you know, selling it. There is a huge demand for this game. For example, there is a site on Xbox where you can vote for, you know, the backwards compatible game that you want next. And Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 is at the top of the list. I remember the days when Black Ops 2 was there. I find it interesting that Modern Warfare 2 and 3 3 are at the top of the list, and they're probably going to stay there because they're remastering all of them. Obviously, we've already got the first one, and it looks like the second one's coming, and probably the third. So they probably don't want to make it backwards compatible and lose those sales. And speaking of sales, Activision knows they can make some serious cash if they remaster it. It was one of the highest selling games, just under Black Ops 3, at 25 million units sold. And evidence that Modern Warfare 3 will be coming is that it is the top selling COD of all time at 30 million units. I was checking out the reviews on the trailer for Modern Warfare 2, and the comment section was the most positive I've ever seen for Call of Duty. They're saying things like, "We need this remastered right now. Still the best Call of Duty title out there, hands down." Another person says, "Back when everybody used to love Call of Duty." And these comments were all from a year ago. And the other person said, "This game is to date my favorite COD in terms of story and multiplayer. So many memories with it." At this point, I'm sure Activision is well aware of these types of reviews and its popularity. The question is, when will this happen? Because at this point, it looks like it probably is. Now, Modern Warfare Remastered came out with Infinity Ward's Infinite Warfare as a bundle pack, but then later on June 27th, they offered Modern Warfare Remastered as a standalone game, and PS4 got it first because they have the exclusive deal, and then Xbox got it 1 month later. So the question is, if they are going to release this, are they going to release it around the same time that they did the first Modern Warfare Remaster? I've seen some gaming articles talk about this, and they're speculating that, yeah, it might be, you know, released the same time that they did the first one last year, and it might be announced at E3 this year. E3 is going to be June 12th through 14th, and if they did the announcement and then released it later on that month, I mean, you know, that could work out. There's also speculation that it could come out with Black Ops 4, but those aren't the same studios, so people are thinking that maybe that's not going to be a possibility. Going back to the price of this game, and that's another question people are asking, is about the price. Now, this price was $39.99, but the listing on Amazon in Italy was for $19.99. Of course, that's in euros, so if you do the conversion, that puts the price at like $24.66, so probably like a $24.99 amount is what we might be looking at. So there's definitely a price difference between the $39.99 and the $24.99, but it could be that this was just a price placeholder in Amazon Italy, didn't really know what the final amount is going to be, so they just put that. There's also been some other speculation as to why this could actually be the price, and it's the possibility that maybe the campaign has been left out or edited down a lot. There were some extreme controversies over one of the missions called No Russian. In this mission, you play as an undercover CIA agent who participates in a mass shooting at a Moscow airport to gain the trust of a Russian terrorist group. In the mission, you have the option to, you know, shoot at the innocent civilians or, you know, keep going or even skip the mission. If you do decide to partake, you do end up shooting at the civilians and, you know, killing the people in the game, and that caused a huge upset in the media. A lot of people thought that it was way too graphic and that it drew upon a 2008 terror attack in Mumbai, India, and that was just a year prior to the release of this game. This mission was blocked in a lot of countries, and with Infinity Ward and, you know, Activision knowing about this, they definitely probably made some changes if they are indeed remastering it and are gonna release it. So less content means a lower price, which, you know, is a possibility. But I hope you guys enjoyed this, and we'll see you next video.